Sagittarius, I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your love lives or your career, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Sagittarians, the big news this month is Mercury retrograde, which begins from 23rd of March and carries on till about 17th of April. We have our own Mercury drill, which is not a great time to be buying electronics, not a great time to be getting into any kind of negotiations, legal or otherwise, not a great time to be signing any new papers, not a great time to be buying or selling, not a great time to be getting married, and also not a great time to be getting into unplanned travel. Good time to be researching, great time to be revising, re-looking at things, tweaking things on a ongoing project. Great time as well to be watching your communication, crossing your T's and dotting your I's. Great time to be doing a lot of research as far as your project is concerned. It can be even your relationship. It's a great time to be ensuring that your travel plans are, the tickets are booked before the retrograde begins. Ensure that that you are careful about forwarding the WhatsApp messages, and that you're extremely careful about the emails as well, that you're not sort of blindly forwarding a mail as an FII with a lot of rubbish which is not required. We're opening the month with a full moon that is there in your house of career, your reputation, and Sagittarians, a lovely time. There seems to be a lot of accolades, a lot of acknowledgement on your work, on your career space. It's a time to be stepping out in style. It's a time for people to be recognizing your mettle and giving you due credit. It also means in certain cases that a job coming to an end. It can be that for some of you, you are you're literally changing your career paths. Maybe you are you have been, say for example, working in a specific industry, and now you drastically change the industry and you move on somewhere else. On the 7th of March, we have Mercury and Venus, which are joining Uranus in the house of your love, romance, creativity and children, and a lot of conversations, a lot of lovely time spent with someone whom you love, with your children being a source of joy. Uranus will bring about its unpredictability, some amount of chaos and a lot of excitement around the love area as well. On the 17th, we have a new moon that is there in your house of home, and it's joining Sun and Neptune. And new moon over here is giving an opportunity. Maybe you're moving into a new house, maybe you're sprucing up a new house. A lot of conversations are around maybe you're shifting your house, maybe there are plans to move your house. For some of you, maybe a new house has just got made and you're busy renovating it, and there's a lot of conversation around it. You're beautifying it, you're making it more comfortable, and it's somewhere become like a very soul-satisfying experience for you. On the 18th, we have Mars that is there in your house of money, and this is also the house of self-worth, and it's joining Pluto and Saturn. And Mars is going to be creating more revenue, earning or making opportunities for you. There's an opportunity for some of you to freelance. There's opportunity for some of you to be diversifying your work and expanding and increasing your work and maybe collaborating with other people. And while this may seem like a lot of work, it may bring about more responsibility, but it will be lucrative for you, Sagittarians. On the 23rd, we have Mercury that goes retrograde in your house of love, romance, creativity. So during the retrograde, it's a good time to be, because it primarily covers your creative project and children. I think it's important to be paying attention on, for those of you who have older kids, that, you know, the values that you are passing them on, what are they? You need to be re-looking at maybe your ways of bringing up your children? What is it that you want to instill with them? What is it that you want, the legacy that you want to leave with them? And you know, we don't really have to be these grand billionaires or people saying, oh, I have this legacy. But when I'm saying legacy from a very simple perspective, what is it that you really believe in, or whether it can be as simple as kindness, compassion, creating opportunities for everyone, treating your staff extremely kindly at home and at work, and how it is, and making your children really accountable for themselves. What is a legacy that you're leaving behind? So this is the entire retrograde. This time you really need to be thinking, and you need to be evaluating. You need to be maybe tweaking that, how it is that you deal with. Is it too much of a servile relationship? Are you sort of so, you know, enamored by your children that you really can't see as to what is it that's happening? And for some of you, it would mean that supporting your children in their creative project. Some of you will be starting or be involved in a very pet project yourselves as well. We are closing the month on the 31st with a full moon that is there in your house of groups of friends, people with whom you maybe hang around socially, clubs, and it's a great sifting time, Sagittarians. You're going to be and Sagittarians, I think that's one zodiac. I think almost everybody is your friend. I mean, you have so many friends. You just absolutely love people, and people love being with you. So this is a time where you're going to be going through the sifting process of, you know, who is it that stays, who is it that leaves, people with whom you want to hang around with, people who add value to your life. And there's just that your filters and your sifting process is really up during this time. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Sagittarians. I'll see you again soon. And thank you so much for watching.